Hey guys, Hoyeonwon here with the video review of the LG G4. Last year's G3 had some really good reviews from a lot of different outlets, and it was perceived as one of the best devices of 2014. And it looks like LG's keeping the same formula, but not without a couple of new additions. In terms of design, the G4 looks a lot like that of its predecessor, including the signature LG power and volume button placements on the back, smooth curved back, and a similar form factor. However, there are some slight differences from the G3 that makes this phone stand out a bit. When you lay this phone on a flat surface, you can see that the screen is slightly curved. It might not be as curved as LG G Flex 2, but it looks like LG is using some of the same tech from that line of device. I don't know if this curved screen enhances my experience in any way, but it does look pretty unique. Another distinction is the design of the back cover. The back cover is made of similar plastic material of the G3, but it looks brushed metal, and there's this diamond shape pattern that makes it a little easier to grip. However, just like many phones with the same materials, this phone is pretty slippery, so if you have dry skin, it might be a little hard to hold on to. I actually dropped the phone a few times by accident and got a few scuffs on the corners. Now, this doesn't happen too frequently, but there is some required caution. FYI, you can get various leather back covers, but the one that LG provided me was a plastic one. So I can't say anything about the experience with the leather covers, but when I do get one, I'm going to be doing a review on that too. And for those of you that like to have replaceable battery and expandable memory, LG's got your back on that part. Even though this is a pretty big phone, the curved back makes this pretty usable with just one hand. Now, certain functions need both hands on the phone, but one hand has been good enough for most things. The overall design might not be the same quality as the HTC One or the iPhone, but the phone does look pretty sleek, and I like the design. The G4 comes with a 5.5-inch IPS LCD display with a QHD resolution of 1440 by 2560 pixels. That sounds identical to the specs of the G3 display, but LG is implementing their quantum display technology, which is supposed to offer better color reproduction and higher brightness levels. But do any of these claims hold up? Yes! This display is stunning. It is one of the best displays I have ever seen on a phone. Colors really do pop, and the resolution does show improvement from standard 1080p displays. The sample video that LG provided with the phone shows this really well, and I replay it many times just to be impressed again and again. Now, the display doesn't get that bright in the sunlight, but is definitely good enough and shouldn't even be considered a downside. It might not be an AMOLED display, but the quantum display shows many characteristics of both LCD and AMOLED, with a sharp resolution and awesome color reproduction. Now, let's talk about software. The G4 comes with Android 5.1 Lollipop right out of the box with the LG UX 4.0 custom UI. LG's UI might follow most of the aesthetics that is Lollipop, with smooth transitions and clean and colorful interfaces, but it is quite intrusive to the stock Android experience, with LG customizations in almost every element of the software. This is not necessarily a bad thing, and in fact, I like this better. There are some really cool new features, and certain LG bloatware apps are better than the stock Android apps. The most blatant new addition to the software is Smart Bulletin. It looks a lot like HTC and Samsung News Reader panels that manufacturers put in place of Google Now. However, LG's Smart Bulletin is not a news reader and is actually a list of LG exclusive features to which you can easily access. You can have your Cure remote on this panel so you can adjust your TV without having to open the app, as well as a music and LG Health app. LG also gives you smart tips to suggest new users on other features that they can try out, so that's pretty cool. The coolest feature from Smart Bulletin is probably the Smart Settings, which lets you customize what your device automatically does in certain situations. For example, I set my Smart Settings so that whenever I plug my headphones in or connect my Bluetooth, my phone automatically opens the Google Music app. This is really useful for when I'm feeling too lazy to go home and having to tap the Music app. There are some other features as well, such as dual window, which is the exact same thing as Samsung's multi-window, where it can use two apps side by side, and there's also the queue slide feature, which lets you use certain apps overlaying your current app. So with these multitasking options, you can basically multitask while multitasking. Kinda unnecessary, but it's nice that there's the option. So, like the variety of the features on the phone, you can essentially customize almost every part of the phone. One of the best parts about this is that you can customize your home touch buttons to include up to 5 buttons. You can put your notification slide down function or even the dual window function on this part of the screen. So there are some really cool software features on this phone and a lot that I haven't even mentioned. There are a lot that might not be very useful, but some that are really useful. Even though the Lollipop experience might have been compromised, I'm really liking what LG's offering here with their own version of Android. Now, for my favorite part of the LG G4, its camera. I'm just going to start off and say that this is the best camera I have ever used on a phone. It might not have the highest megapixel count at 16 megapixels, but megapixels definitely isn't the decider on the quality of this camera. As you can see from the samples, picture quality is very good. Colors are vibrant and very accurate with the G4's new color spectrum sensor, and even on auto, this camera is able to capture any sort of shot fairly accurately with great depth of field. It also comes with the f1.8 aperture, which really helps shoot in low light situations and shooting in fast speeds. It might not be the fastest, but with the quality each picture is able to capture, it's pretty damn fast. LG's custom camera app lets you take full control of this fantastic camera with extensive manual controls. You can adjust aperture, ISO, change to raw image processing, and more. I'm not a professional photographer, so I won't be fiddling around with this too much, but camera enthusiasts will surely appreciate this. Like most phone cameras these days, you're able to record in 4K, and video does look fantastic as the G4 comes with OIS, and panning shots like these at the beach are very smooth, and even clips of me walking while holding the phone seems to hold up pretty well. So overall, the G4's camera is probably the best phone camera I've ever used, and it certainly won't disappoint any of you from getting this device. Let's talk about the actual performance of this phone. So the LG G4 comes with a Snapdragon 808 6-core processor with 3GB of RAM and 32GB of onboard storage. The processor performs pretty well as I'm able to navigate throughout almost all aspects of the phone, including opening apps and playing games in swift speeds. Even multitasking with dual window and Q-Slide doesn't lag the phone that much, and I'm very satisfied with the actual speeds. There are some slowdowns, but the blame should really be on Android Lollipop, as these slowdowns on specific parts of the UI navigation happens on every Android phone with Lollipop. Wi-Fi signal doesn't appear to be that strong, as I've been able to use Wi-Fi from further areas around the house with my other phones, but if I do have a strong signal with this device, data speeds are very fast. LTE speeds are a bit of a different story, as LTE speeds just don't seem to be that fast in my area. It might be because this phone is the international version, so in terms of data speeds, don't hold my opinion accountable. The G4 also comes with a 3000 mAh battery, which isn't that fantastic. In my last few weeks of playing with the phone, I have found the performance of the battery to be very inconsistent. Now, I'm not saying that the battery is bad, as it does generally get me through the day, but it's mostly limited to 3 hours of on-screen time, which isn't that impressive considering the size of the battery. In the end, the LG G4 is a good phone. A really good phone. The design of the hardware and UI might not be the sexiest, but the amount of software features, awesome camera, and great overall performance makes this one of the best phones I've ever played with. There are some problems here and there, but the pros definitely outweigh the cons. This will be my personal device until the next great thing, and it should be the same for you too. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video review of the LG G4. I'm also going to be doing a giveaway of another brand new LG G4 that LG graciously sent me, so stay tuned to this channel for more info on that giveaway. And if you're interested in tech news, other giveaways, and more, please subscribe to my channel and follow me on Facebook and Google+. And I'll see you guys on the next video. See ya!